Hey, everybody. As many of you know, I'm a huge fan of fire suppression systems in race cars. Definitely want you guys to be safe. And fire, of course, is the biggest problem that we have in racing as far as the dangers. So today I want to talk a little bit about fire suppression. As many of you know, I absolutely love fire bottle. So we're going to look at how do you install these, because that's a big question that I get on the website is how do you even install these systems? So before we actually take a look at the components in the car, I want to talk a little bit about the orientation and how you want to mount these. Now, some guys like to mount them vertically, and that is okay. However, one problem can happen. In order for this system to work, it basically has a straw that goes to the bottom of this bottle. And if you end up having to be upside down, that straw is just has nothing to draw from. So you could, even having a suppression system in your car, it could be non-functional if you end up in that situation. So really, rather than mounting it vertical, and you never want to mount it in an inverted position like this, you want to mount it sideways. That is really the preferred method. Now you can mount it like sideways in the car just like this, or sideways pointing, you know, one of the directions, and that those are both possibilities. So with the installation we're going to do today, we'll go ahead and go on over to the car. Now, Fire Bottle offers a few different systems. The bottle I was just showing you is a 10-pound system, and this one is a 10-pound system as well. Now, this is the AMRC 1002. It's the one we refer to as the Lucas Oil system. It's the one that's approved for World Racing Group and for Lucas Oil. Well, it's not just approved, it's mandated. But there are some different versions, so there are different brackets that come in the different kits. With this AMRC 1002 system, it comes with these brackets, and as you can see, we have decided to mount this at a side to side right here, and we've already got the brackets in place. Now what we're going to do with the automatic lines, because this system has two automatic lines, and to explain what those are, the automatic line, if you're not familiar with these, at the end of this line is I'm going to take off this protective cap here, but there's a little piece of glass or a little glass tube in here. When it reaches 170 degrees, this glass will automatically break and it'll set off the system. So that is what is meant by an automatic line. Now this system will also have manual lines, but I won't be able to show you those until we get in the interior into this car, and we'll come back and do that installation. But for now, I wanted to show you where we were going to place the bottle and also where we're going to point these lines. So this first line, there's this shorter line here, which is, I think this is about 2 feet or so, but this line we're going to end up pointing towards the fuel cell, because that is one of the biggest dangers. If you end up upside down and your fuel starts on fire, that's a very critical piece. And of course, since these cars don't have rear view mirrors, you don't even know what's happening, so you can't even pull off the system yourself because you don't even know what's happening. So this way, we're going to mount this to the top of the interior when that happens. The other line we have coming from this side, and it's going towards the front, and that is going to end up in the cockpit, and we will do more on the installation there as well. So this is part one of the installation, and let's come back in a moment to show you putting in those lines. Now our next step, of course, we have the bottle and we've showed you where the position is in the car, and then it was time to go ahead and put more of the body onto the car. And of course we need to mount the seat and get all the cockpit ready before we can finish installing the rest of the lines. Now, as you'll see in this portion, we have already run the automatic nozzle to the fuel cell. And as I may have explained earlier, it has that little glass section in there, so it'll automatically break at 170 degrees, and that protects our driver in that case. So now we're going to move on to installing the lines in the cockpit, and because we are installing a system that is both manual and automatic, this will give the driver a chance to actually pull a pull cord and set off the system himself rather than having to wait in the instance of a fire. So what we want to do is we want to seat our driver in the car and then be able to look around in the cockpit to find the exact spot where he wants to put that pull cable. Then we're going to drill a hole, right, and you can see we've drilled a hole, and then we will install the pull cable right there in that hole. This is our pull cable right here for the AMRC 1002. We've already installed the safety pin. The safety pin, if this is in place, the system will not go off. It's a good way to keep your system from going off accidentally when you're transporting, but you always want to make sure that you pull that pin before you go racing in order to activate your system and have it ready to be able to go off. So what we're going to do now is that hole that we've drilled in the cockpit, we're going to thread this through, and then on the back side, we'll put a nut on the other side to lock it in place.
Next up, we want to route both our automatic and our manual lines to the cockpit. Now what's great is the fire bottle system comes with lots of different hardware. One of these is the T-piece, and we're using it in this installation to connect from the cockpit and able to go into the engine compartment. With these lines in place, we want to go ahead and install that manual line at the fire bottle at the cap. So here we're adding that manual cable right here to the top of our fire bottle. And we want to make sure that we go ahead and adjust that set screw that's at the cap as well. And of course, we don't want to have any loose lines in our whole fire bottle system set up here. So using wire ties, we're attaching them right along where any of our lines are being run. With all of our lines installed, we're gonna go ahead and pull the pin, and that way we're ready to go and ready to get on the track, knowing that that fire bottle is in place, installed, and ready to go. You can find fire bottles on our website at crateinsider.com. Pick up a system today. Be safe, make it happen.